from the mountain to the prairie to the ocean, white with foam. God bless America.
Welcome once again to the Watchdog Report. My name is Ed Ciffone, the Yorktown Watchdog and President of the United Taxpayers of Yorktown. Listen, folks, I just want to start off the show. I'm also campaign manager for Gregory Kane, who is running for office, county legislator in the 4th District. So I just want to make sure that I do my job every week. It's going to be in November 5th is the election, and you'll hear he'll be sitting here a lot, and he'll be telling you his platform. So again, he got 750 signatures, which you need to get on the ballot for the Republican Party. So that's done. Let's hope for the best. It stays that way. And we'll update you as we go along. Now, today is a funny thing, is that Ed Ciffone, your town watchdog, is going to introduce John Davis, Austin watchdog, who moved to Yorktown. So, John, let me say hello.
Hey, thank
nice
you for having
see.
Me. Appreciate
and,
it.
And now that you're a member of the United Taxpayers, okay? So this is really great. Two watchdogs sitting together. So this is good. So first, a little bit about yourself and how long you've been in Yorktown. And
sure. I've only been in Yorktown for 6 months now. Moved in at the beginning of the year, 2013.
Talk to me.
And my background, I've been, I spent 30 years as a corporate purchasing manager and also as a business owner. So that's okay. Been my past business experience.
Okay, great.
Yeah, so I'm a little bit younger than I look.
Okay.
Or so, older
so
than I look.
So why did you move into Yorktown?
I had to sell a property I owned in Austin. You know, I had lost the job. And I had difficulties like
everybody
many Americans.
Right.
So I needed to cash out on my property, and so right now I'm currently renting in Yorktown, still obviously still a taxpayer.
Right. Yeah. So listen, now we know we're against high taxes.
Yeah.
So tell us a little bit about what you did in Austin, and. I'll tell you a little bit what we've done over the last 23 years here.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
I couldn't go to a barbecue in Austin with friends, or I couldn't walk my dog without hearing about people complaining about taxes, myself included. So I figured, well, someone's got to do something. And then I was like, well, I guess I should do something.
Right.
So I started a group on Facebook, simply called Austin Taxpayers.
Okay.
As of today, there was about 280 members on Austin Taxpayer, as well as another 200 to 300 members on Austin Taxpayers on LinkedIn.
Okay. So tell them that we now, the United Taxpayers of Yorktown, is on your Facebook page, right?
Of course.
Yeah,
since we've been in touch, I started a website on Facebook called United Taxpayers of Yorktown, which is your baby.
Right, it's great. So that's great. So you've been here, we've met a couple of weeks back. We had a meeting with everybody. Everybody agreed that it was going to be great. Okay, so which was good. So when I started, my wife had said, if we don't do something about the taxes, we have to move to North Carolina. So that was a long time ago.
Right.
So that was in 1990 when I first ran for a school board. So you got taxes, you got the school, the county, and the town meeting, okay? And then you got the income tax you got to pay. So the biggest one is the school. Do you live in the Yorktown School District?
I do.
Okay, yeah. So they have a $93 million budget. And what you're going to hear from me is surplus, what they call fund balance, okay? They raise taxes every year. This year they raised it $1.8 million with a surplus of $7.7 million. This is extra money. They put it in reserves, and they put it in the 4%, which is $3.6 million they can keep by law, okay?
So
and they're still raising taxes.
So they raised taxes, but they already had a reserve of $7.7
million? Yeah.
Why would they need to have raised taxes?
Well, that's why we're fighting
okay.
this.
Okay? Yes, sir.
Because what they did, since the 2% cap came in, now they're charging you right up to the cap. And they're saying, well, we were under the cap, right? But you didn't have to raise taxes that high, okay? And when the cap wasn't there, I'll just give you $1.8 million this year, it was $89,000 went out the cap 3 years ago. $89,000, that was it, spending. So you think what's going on. And of course, what they spend it on is salaries and benefits, okay? And I say this all the time to people so they don't understand. The superintendent of schools in Yorktown makes $264,355 a year. That's approximately $1,000 a day. So talk about taxes. Okay. Now, have you had any successes in Austin?
Yes, we have. I believe it was 2010, the Austin School Board deemed that they needed $75 million. And it was a one-third, one-third, one-third tax or bond. One-third for maintenance, one-third for mandatory upgrades, and another one-third for unnecessary upgrades. It included an atrium and some stuff that was, so $25 million represented something that was completely unnecessary.
Right.
So we got I really give credit to more of the people in my group. But I'll take this much credit. So we defeated that bond. The bond was ridiculous. We had, in our group, we had quite a few people picketing the school for a no vote.
Right.
Huh. So the no vote, it was 1,500, about approximately 1,500 no votes to approximately 800 or 900 yes votes.
Well, that's really good. Just in Yorktown, it was 700 to 300. Only 1,063 people voted.
Mm.
So that's pretty kind of ridiculous. Okay?
That's rough.
Yeah, okay. So we did the same thing. We've over the past years, we've defeated budgets. We defeated bond issues or reduced bond issues, okay? We inform people. That's what we do, and that's what we do on this show. And since you joined up, so it's good. We'll join forces. So did they call you the Austin Watchdog?
I was more just like the Austin taxpayer. We had the Austin Taxpayer Association, Austin taxpayer. I just kind of took the lead on a lot of projects, but to be honest with you, there was a lot of people who did a lot more work than me.
Right.
You know, and there was quite a few people, you know, I don't know if I can mention their names on this.
Yeah, you could, but you don't have to. But you want to give them a thank you. In general, you say thank you to everybody.
Want to thank the good people of Austin for really helping out with a lot of issues that we were successful in accomplishing.
Well, that's what we did. And we didn't pick it, but we did. We attend a lot of the meetings. We wrote letters. We did a lot of stuff to get these things down, okay? But the thing is, when you add the local tax, the county, and the school, it's a lot of money.
It's a lot of money.
Okay? So now, just to let you know about the surplus again, fund balance, in town, $4.6 million in extra money.
Okay.
1% is $175,000. So you got $4.6 million. Okay, so we tried as the Yorktown, we go before the budget, we asked them to put a limitation on how much they could keep in this surplus fund balance, okay? So they had something like 25%. So we said, why don't you get 10%? The school's doing 4, 10 for you, you got a smaller budget, would be great. So then in the auditor's report, it said they should make a policy. So the supervisor of town, Michael Grace, said, yeah, we'll do it, but they haven't done it. So we were satisfied if they would have put something in writing for 15%, because that's our money. They just overtax you.
Was there any constitutionality to that? Was there
it just said that the auditor said put it in writing as a policy.
Gotcha.
Just like New York State has a policy for the school districts. They can have more than 4%.
And what was Mr. Grace's reason for not lowering that?
Well, he said he was going to do it.
Oh, he said.
But he hasn't done it.
Oh.
Now, the reason, and the second thing was also, was he was supposed to have a finance committee of people in Yorktown, and we sent in our resumes, and that hasn't come.
Okay.
So those are the two things that says, if you want me to vote for you,
okay,
you got to do those two things.
Well, so, I don't really know. Michael Gray seems like a good man to me.
Yeah.
And I know if he made a promise to do something.
Right, that's all I'm saying. Yeah.
I'm sure he's going to come through on that promise.
Well, what happens is that they say one thing and they do another. He'll give like this, well, maybe 15% to 18%, okay? And why he's not having a finance committee? Because the ex-supervisor of the town who ran against him wants to be on there, and she did a lot of good stuff with numbers and keeping taxes down. So those are some of the reasons why maybe you don't want to have it,
okay?
But anyway, this is politics. So in Ossining, how many... We have about 37,000 people here in it.
Ossining is a hybrid. Ossining is a town and a village.
Oh.
And approximately 25,000 people in the village. And I believe about another 10,000 in the town.
Okay, so about 35.
Very fragmented for a municipality that shares the same name.
Right, yeah. Because they have two police departments?
Okay. That's another thing. Now, I'm not going to take credit for this. What I wanted to do was to merge the Ossining Village Police Department with the Ossining Town Police Department.
Right.
What Catherine Borgia did, which...
Who is she, the supervisor?
I'm sorry, she was a supervisor of the town of Ossining. What Catherine did was, I guess she went out for a bid from Westchester County Police Department, and... Now the town, the 10,000 people in town, it's patrolled by the Westchester County Police.
Already?
Oh,
okay.
This actually happened, it's 2 years ago now.
Oh, okay. So that's a big saving.
Now, hold on a second.
Okay, go ahead.
That was supposed to be a $900,000, close to $1 million a year savings.
Right, okay.
There was some problems with police overtime that were... I guess weren't written into the contract very well. So the savings diminished.
Oh.
And since I've been out of Ossining, I really haven't been involved. I believe there's still a savings there, but I couldn't say for sure. But the police overtime diminished the $900,000 a year savings to X amount.
Okay. Well, see, they're all good ideas. You consolidate. And the same thing with the courts. They do the courts, they're consolidating the courts and everything else. You cut down on the personnel, you cut down on the salaries, cut down on benefits. And if you get the same service and the same coverage, it's really, really, really good.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that's how it works. In Yorktown, we have now about 51 police officers, okay? And they just have a contract for the last 5 years. Something like between 2.5% and 3.5%. So when you do it 5 years, it comes out to over 12% increase.
Wow.
So that was one of those big numbers. In the past, the Yorktown budget-to-budget increase was in maybe $350,000 around there, no more than $400,000. This time it was $1.3 million.
Wow.
Okay, that's a lot, right? This is Grace did this, okay? And because the previous supervisor never gave them a raise to the police.
So they went years without raises. So now they're playing catch-up.
Yeah, now they're playing catch-up, but that catch-up is a lot to the taxpayer, you know? And now these guys, patrolmen, are making really, really good money. And I think it's after 3 to 5 years and you're on top salary.
Yeah.
And it's a big, big part of the budget.
Yeah, police in all of Westchester County are well paid.
Right, and it's a necessary thing. You got to have police.
Police are we need them. They keep us safe. They're necessary,
right.
And they keep our children safe.
Right,
and they probably even know. I mean, I think everybody in the county knows that any police officer in Westchester County has a solid salary. You know, has a really robust salary.
Eventually,
and benefits.
Yeah, because they hire them at really low, and then they do really good. Talking about that, now, New York State, and Governor Cuomo, now, there's good things about this guy, and there's bad things that are happening, okay? I just want you to fill me out. Now, he made this called the SAFE Act, where police officers are really carrying illegal weapons and illegal ammunition. I think I don't even know if they took it out of there yet, okay? But we know we have resource officers at the school and one of the bar law you're not supposed to have guns at the school. This is ridiculous, and they got a police officer there. So he's coming out with a lot of things. And the thing that I like best is that he mentions corruption, okay? Now, this is the biggest thing. Sheldon Silver, he mentions that he wants to get him out, okay? The head of the Senate got arrested already. This guy's the head of the Assembly. He's been there for years. He got all these garbage things against him, and he's still sitting there. So what do you think about corruption or my, you know, overall?
Yeah, in terms of Sheldon Silver, I don't know the intricacies. My guess personally is I don't think he'll be around very long. I think we need new blood in Albany anyway.
Yeah, right. Been there for a very long time.
Yeah. But you know, I love and hate Andrew Cuomo.
I feel the same way. Yeah.
But his new policy, his new anti-corruption policy, again, I'll use that word robust. It seems really robust. Because it'll not only shine a light on politicians or corrupt politicians, let's say, but it's shining the light on on the budgets, on town, on village, on hamlet. I don't care what municipality you're in. Cuomo's going to shine a light not only on politicians, but municipal workers and their budgets.
Okay.
Now, that's not to scare these workers. These are workers we need. These are workers that are essential to our services.
Well, he just raised the minimum wage, you know, so that's going to come out to $9 an hour.
Okay.
So like I said, you like
it. I didn't even know that.
Yeah, Sully.
But I think this is one of the things I really like Cuomo for.
Okay.
He's got this task force on anti-corruption, which is going to keep a check on our leaders, our politicians, and our municipal budgets.
Yeah. What was good he mentioned also, he would like to see the parties put back a little bit by registering as non-affiliated voters. But that means these people don't belong to the Republicans, the Democrat, Independence Party. But they can vote. They should vote like in other states whenever there's an election. And they're not tied to anything, okay? Because people just vote Republican, just vote, and even though they're corrupt people. We had Alan Hevesy, who was the controller of the town of New York State, who won the election after he was arrested. But he was still on the ballot.
Oh.
and people voted for him because they knew who he was.
I vaguely remember that.
Give me a break. You voted for a crook. Okay. But anyway. Yeah, so I'm hoping that's what happens. And the last governor that was in there, he made like 136 new taxing laws, which tax everything, even water. You know, they tax everything. So every time you turn around, there's another tax. So that's what we are. We're tax activists to try to lower taxes. I had Rob Astorino sitting right there.
I was just going to mention Rob's name.
Yeah, okay. So Rob Astorino, right? He's reduced taxes. He reduced personnel. I asked him, why don't you take off the sales tax on home heating oil? And then he just kept quiet because it's revenue, you know?
Oh.
So then I said, you're not saying much, but why don't you just do it for the heating season, you know? And he didn't say anything either. I've been down to the county at least 6 or 7 times for that same purpose.
Yeah.
People can't live in their homes. They're freezing. Besides the price of oil and gas, whatever it is, you got this surcharge. The only surcharge in New York is Westchester County.
Well, Rob, what I'll say about Rob is he's a model. He's a model for good government.
Good government, yeah.
He has done exceptional things in Westchester County. I think Westchester County has reduced its budget. It's reduced the tax levy. It's reduced the burden. It's reduced the tide of high taxes within the county. So Rob really is a model. I can't speak to the fuel tax that you're talking about.
Right.
I just found this is new
information.
Well,
when you're renting out, that owner, if he has oil, heats the building, he pays that every time he orders oil.
Okay.
At the outrageous, almost $4 a gallon.
I'll talk to him.
Yeah,
I will.
It. But that's, we wanted two things. We wanted to get that off, because it's it's an election year. And also with the voting to make it non-people that Cuomo was pushing, okay? So those are some of the things that we're looking for. And with Gregory Kane running for county legislator, and John Tester, who's also part of Yorktown, they all work together with Rob Astorino as Republicans, okay? And that's what they need, okay?
Right, right.
And some Democrats do work along with Rob, which is good, but most of the time they just veto whatever he says and stuff like that, okay? So, but this is the season that politicians are out there, and now you got to ask them, listen, you want me to vote for you? You know, hey, this is what I want to do. See what you could do.
Yeah.
Okay? But sales tax, you know, and the highest thing is school taxes, okay? And it's always on the property owner to pay the school taxes. Why don't they spread the wealth around, you know? Make it sales tax. Then everybody's included, okay? Partial sales tax, partial property tax. Lotto money, some of it goes to the schools, but a lot of it goes to the general fund. Okay?
Right, right.
And what they were talking about is circuit breaker for the state. That means everybody that has an income, depending on your income, would pay a certain amount of money.
Mm-hmm.
So it would spread out the wealth, because people can't afford to live here anymore.
Right. Oh, can I just pivot on that?
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah.
You know, just a little quick story about my, you know, my personal family. You know, I've got a brother and a sister in town. My brother works, you know, he's a teacher. He works year round, full time, very hard. They got two little babies and a grown teenage daughter. My sister-in-law has two jobs as a nurse.
Oh.
I don't even know if they have any downtime. Talk right. about stress.
Oh, yeah, right.
So this is not uncommon that, you know, people hearing this out there, you know, might be saying to me, hey, that's me.
Right.
And, you know, you're talking about people with tax burdens in this town between $15,000 to $20,000 a year.
Right.
That's ridiculous. Now imagine the average salary in Westchester County is only about $75,000 per household.
Yeah, right, yeah.
So do the math.
Yeah, I don't know, like,
if you're spending $15,000 a year in taxes, and your household income is only $75,000, after taxes,
plus your mortgage.
Exactly.
Yes, it's crazy.
You've basically got nothing left over.
So we tell people on every one of these shows, okay, do you have the STAR program? If you want, okay, if you're over 65. And make under $79,050. Do you have the enhanced STAR program? That's money off the school taxes, okay? Then you have senior exemptions. They make under $29,000. Some people are old and only have Social Security. They can get 50% off their school, county, and town taxes. So I tell these people to go to the assessor's office and see what you qualify for. Veterans. There's a lot of veterans out there supposed to get exemptions from property taxes. And the last thing I always tell people is to grieve your taxes, because your house isn't valued as much anymore.
Right.
It may reduce it, and then yearly you get a reduction.
What's the date for grievances? Do you know?
Yeah, it's past now. You got a short time period in June to the third week in June.
Okay.
But you can have it all done before that, and we have people ourselves that will do it for the people, and they see with a telephone call. If you'd be able to save money. If not, they won't do it. Okay?
The other thing I just want to say is, imagine, you know, the unemployment numbers out there. There's people on unemployment in Yorktown. Now imagine if you're on unemployment and, you know, no one in the household is working or one parent is working. That $10,000 or $15,000 bill still has to be paid. So... These are the unseen people in...
On unemployment now, I just like to tell these people a little something about that.
Sure.
Now, it's 26 weeks of whatever you're getting, whatever they give you, and then it stops.
Right.
But if you do that 26 weeks and you work in that 26 weeks, say you work 2 days a week, that 26 weeks plus 2 days are added on. And if you work the next week, so... Try to tell people they want that big $405, but if they work part-time, they can still collect unemployment.
See, a lot of that's good,
because
a lot of people, actually, I was on unemployment at one time. I don't know if that existed,
It always exists, yeah.
Oh, I never knew.
Yeah, it's either 4 days, more than 4 days, you can't get anything, or more than $405.
Mm.
So even if you work 1 day at two jobs,
mm-hmm.
consider 1 day.
Okay.
as long as you make underneath that $405. And it was great for the cops that were like working 6 months on they retired.
Right.
So they work 6 months and they can collect unemployment for 6 months. Mm. And that's really, every person is different. If you need that money for 26 weeks and you can find a job, that's great. Yeah, yeah. But if you can find a part-time at that time, apply for unemployment, okay?
That's good information.
Yeah, yeah, and here's another one we try to tell people. Now, if you're over 65 and both people are getting Social Security, if one makes less than 50% of the other, the one at the lower rate can make the same as the person at the higher rate. So people don't know that.
Oh, okay.
So that's pretty amazing. So if I made 1,000 and your wife makes 400, that's less than 50%. Yeah, they go, and she gets the 1,000. And plus you get it. See, these are the things that I do on this show all the time.
Gotcha.
Over and over, how to save.
That's good information.
Yeah, how to save money. So, you know, I repeat all the time, but you have to repeat all the time.
Yeah.
So let me ask you this question now. In Austin, you did all that stuff. You made some victories, okay? And now you join the UTY as a member. So this is great that you put us on Facebook and that you're here today.
Yes, sir.
So it's really good. And we have a great organization. We used to send newsletters out every 3 to 4 months. And then it used to get expensive, you know, because you got to pay for the paper, okay? So what we'll try to do in September is our start of the year. So with our guys, it's only $10 a year for registration fee, and then we give you 50% off at BJ's.
That's
shop.
A, that's so a sweet deal.
Yeah, which is a
pretty
good
sweet
deal.
Because I think the BJ's card is 55
yeah,
50, a year?
58 or something like that. They keep going up, you know. So
that's a savings of at least $20 a year.
Right, half of it, right. So that's really good. And then you support us by that $10. And in September at my house, we'll have a barbecue with the members and try to get everybody to sign up again and all that
I can't
stuff.
Make it. No, I'm joking.
No, that's good.
I'll be there.
We'll see. I'll be there.
I'm just keeping you
So listen, there's only a minute or so ago. So end it by looking at that camera and tell them anything you want.
Thank you.
The people to know, okay?
Thank you, Ed. I just want to say that for taxes to go lower, taxpayers must get involved. That's the only way. You must contact your local leaders. You must get involved. You know, this is, you know, we are still United States. We are a government of the people, by the people, and for the people.
Right.
And we are the people. So the politicians will do as much as they can, but they need us. They need us to help. They need us to get involved. They need us to push for lower taxes. You could email, you can pick up a phone, you could, you know, walk to your local village meeting, in town meeting in Yorktown. Please get involved in some way. We really need to get involved.
All right, listen, thank you for coming. We'll have you sitting in that chair again. And listen, folks, this is the United Taxpayers sign-up sheet, okay? So listen, you'll see the graphics. Please call me at my home at 914-245-1018, okay? And join the UTY, just like John did. And let's not forget my job to get this man elected, Gregory Kane, for county legislator in the 4th degree. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next week. And John, thanks again for coming.
Hey, thank you for having me, sir.
We'll be a team out there.
Thank you, sir.
From the mountains.